All right, yo, yo, shalom, salutations, everybody. Welcome back to another video right here. This is the Sacramento Truth Movement. You know, my name is Two Leader Jay. You know, welcome back. Thanks for tuning in once again. Now, this is my April, moving into, you know, the next coming month, 2024 book overhaul. You know, I've done a few of these so far over the last, what, I don't know how long, but I've recently acquired some new books coming in that I bought off of eBay, and a majority of those fall into the Masonic spectrum, but a few of those don't. So I'm gonna get right into it with the other ones that I bought that don't really have a kind of Freemason, you know, vibe to it, but the rest of them will fall right into what the title of this video is. The second part, you know, will show off what I bought also. But if anybody wants to buy any kind of, you know, religious context books, eBay is the best place to buy these, because I'm getting these for like 15, 11, 12, 18, 17, 50, 20, 22 to about $25. And, you know, they come pretty fast. I got most of these about a week ago. I'm just now getting around to recording this video. So, you know, what's up, everybody? But, getting into that, yeah, if you want to buy any of these, I think I'd done, got some of the best ones that eBay sells, the people that put them on there. But I'm sure these are always getting listed on there, and they're always getting bought. So if you want to look at one of those and, you know, want to acquire some of these, you know, eBay, and do it as fast as you can, because, you know, these probably sell like clockwork, if you know what I mean. And if you can't do that and you don't have any money, let this, you know, be a opportunity to reach out to somebody who has, you know, some of these books that, you know, truth seekers and, you know, truth tellers, you know, would be interested in watching and learning from and looking to see what's inside some of these quote on Masonic Bibles and paraphernalia that not everybody usually has. And now I just want to get this across, leave this as a disclaimer. I am not a Freemason. I have no ties or family member ties or any kind of ties to any organization in the Masonic body. For those who are schizophrenic and say, oh, this is him revealing himself, no, this is me having money from working a 9-to-5 job and having spare money to order stuff that eBay sells. You can go on there, you can see what they sell, and you can put it in like that, and it's that easy. You know what I'm saying? So this isn't me revealing myself, because, you know, you get some of these weirdos out here saying that. I just wanted to leave that across, so let's get into that. All right, so starting off, I got the Gnostic Gospels, the Nag Hammadi, the Gnostic Wisdom of Jesus, including the Lost Apocryphal Gospel of Thomas, John, and Mary Magdalene. I bought this, I think, for about $20. Could be right on that. Could have been about 18. It was either 18 to about maybe roughly like 22. I believe, and it came within like 3 days, you know, not too bad, you know, these come pretty well. I get the ones that have free delivery, but sometimes, you know, if it's cheap, and the delivery is like $3 or $4, I'll get it. But I do have another one of these. I do have another Gnostic Gospels. I show that, I believe, in one of my last book overhauls. And that one was real small. I actually boosted that from the library, believe it or not. And now this one I actually have spent my own hard-earned money on. So, you know, there's wisdom in that, you know what I mean? So just flip this around real quick. All right, the Gospel of Mary. A gospel as ancient and authentic as any gospels that the Christian Bible contains, was buried deep in the Egyptian desert after an edict was sent out in the 4th century to have all copies of it destroyed. Fortunately, some rebel monks were wise enough to refuse, and thanks to their disobedience and spiritual bravery, we have several manuscripts of the only gospel that was written in the name of a woman. The Gospel of Mary Magdalene restores to the forefront of the Christian tradition importance of all of the divine feminine and offers a new perspective on life of one of the most controversial figures in the Western spiritual tradition. This brief narrative presents a radical interpretation of Jesus' teaching as a path to inner spiritual knowledge. It rejects his suffering and death as a path to eternal life. The Gospel of John. What that just read is the gist on how the Nag Hammadi was found. John preaches the coming of a new man, the genesis of the man of knowledge in this volume, the Gospel of Thomas. Jesus describes a journey from a limited to unlimited consciousness. The Jesus of Thomas invites us to drink deeply from the well of knowledge that lies within, not so that we may become a good Christians, but so we may attain the self-knowledge that will make each of us to a Christ. And this is what it looks like inside. It's not really too many illustrations, or if any. Haven't actually went over this yet, as it was one of the later books that came in so far. But there's like the context on what to expect. But that is the Gnostic Gospels, the Nag Hammadi Library. All right, next thing that I got was Geneva Bible, 1560, the Apocrypha. So what this is basically, it's the Apocrypha with pertaining to the Geneva Bible. While not universally regarded as canonical, the Apocrypha provides a profound insights into the human experience and matters of faith. Through engagement with these texts, we deepen our understandings of the complexities of religious thought. Timeless Truth Editions. So what the Apocrypha is, it's the Dead Sea Scrolls. Later iteration as the apocryphal books are the Apocrypha, and it's doesn't pertain to having Enoch inside of it. If anybody's wondering that, Enoch is not in the Apocrypha, it's its own thing, but it was found with the Dead Sea Scrolls where these books will be listed in the Holy Bible. So the Geneva is before the King James. If you get those King James only, it's, you know, we get the it's a King James, Tyndale, Wycliffe, Geneva. There's older versions than just the King James. So my thing would be, do they also subscribe to the older texts? Because these actually would be more closer to the original source than the King James version, KJV itself. And the English in here appears to be an older form of English with a mixture of Latin than what the KJV has with thous and thy. See what I mean? Book of Tobit, Apocrypha. Wisdom of Solomon, what well dome of Solomon. So you get the gist, the wisdom of Solomon. It's good on having, you know. I didn't know the English would be like this, but you know, I do have it on hand now, so I like having these hardcover copies, you know, in case, you know, stuff out here in the future happens, and then truth be told, we don't have the internet no more, and I can't charge my phone because we don't have the electricity funds and means to do so. So, bam, it's best to get these while you can, because that, unfortunately, is reality, and those could happen in any partake, if you know what I mean. But moving on. All right, this is my Oxford Text Bible. Made in Great Britain. It's the Order of the Eastern Stars Pocket Edition to the Oxford Text Masonic Bible. And now this one's actually pretty. And here we have the Masonic Eastern Star inverted pentagram. Now, why do the Eastern Star have the inverted pentagram? Nobody really knows. And when you ask them, because I've already asked many members of this female Masonic body order, they'll give you a rundown on the 5 points, and they represent the 5 female heroes of the Bible. And that's fine and all, and then sometimes they'll go into the description, because usually these 5 have their own distinct colors. And that's kind of what these are right here, I believe. We got white, green, red, blue, yellow. So, you know, that's what the colors are for right here, these tassels. And they'll give you definitions on the symbology right here. But see, here's the thing. They'll never go into the description on why their symbol is an inverted star. You know, pentagram. Why is that? Why is that? But that's a whole nother discussion. But I thought I would bring that up. This one's actually pretty. I forgot how much this was. It's kind of small, you know. But, you know, decently sized. Get in the back. Oh, so, pocket edition Bible. This one doesn't have any of the illustrations. But I do believe most of these Masons have See, this one wasn't owned by anybody that I know of to the initiate. But yeah, that's the Oxford Text Bible, Oxford Text Masonic Bible, Order of the Eastern Star Pocket Edition. You know, so moving along to the next one, a little bit bigger than this. All right. So this one, I believe was about 20. I didn't spend over $25. I know that. I believe. But this one, I believe, was about maybe 25. Could have been. But I'm not sure. Now, this one necessarily wasn't owned by anybody, but I believe this is a blue letter. I believe that's what it is. Masonic Bible. I forgot what the description was. But that's not really important, because the bigger one that I showed the other day, that was red letter. That was a Master Mason's reference Bible. I'm going to show that next. But this one, I like the color on this one. I'm not going to lie. I like this color blue. Now, this one, I don't think was owned by anybody. Just like the last one, no, because it would have been presented in by... Here we go. Holy Bible containing the Old and New Testament, authorized or King James Version with study helps. Heirloom Bible Publishers. Wichita, Kansas. www.masonicbibles.com. Huh. Yeah, no, it wasn't owned by anybody. This one's... there we got the dual eagle. It's a 32. Oh, interesting. No, 33. It's visiting brethren and friends. Ancient and accepted Scottish Rite record, brother. York Rite record. Oh, here we go. This is interesting. Plan of the orders of Masonry. See this? For those truth seekers, you might want to clip this one right here. See that? Yeah. Aerial view. Going in. Alright. So that's just a rundown on all the descriptions of the titles of each degree in Masonry. And it's like, could probably do a rundown of most of this, but that's this one in a sense right here. Alright, moving along. Alright, now this next one is the Master Mason referenced Bible, and I believe this is red letter, and we've seen one of these before, but I never looked into one, and I've already shown this off. You know, that's funny because this is that's the Harry Potter font, or it looks just like it, and I've shown this one off in a previous video because it's pretty big. So I'm not going to cover too much into it, but this was previously owned by somebody else. May this old book bring you many years of happiness. May it, he, I don't know. Love, Johnny. 6/2000. Damn, that's a while ago. Brother Frank Allen by Johnny Lee something. Can't really read that. That's crazy. 2000. So the running belief in Freemasonry is that Jesus himself was a Mason. And they'll tell you that. Let's see. Keep going. There's a lot of this one has the illustrations. It's Holy Bible, Authorized or King James Version, Old and New Testament, translated out of the original tongues and with all former translations diligently compared and revised, red letter edition, pictorial pronouncing dictionary, and other interesting instructive features. A family Bible, beautifully illustrated masterpiece of religious art. Heirloom Bible Publishers. Table of contents. Books of the Old and New Testament. There's George Washington. He was a Mason. And then they got a picture of him right here. Here's the eye that's on the dollar bill. All right. Skipping a page. Masonic presidents of our country. And here's a list of all the presidents that were Freemasons in our history of the United States. George Washington, James Madison, James Monroe, Andrew Jackson, James Knox Polk, James Buchanan, Andrew Johnson, James A. Garfield, William McKinley, Theodore Roosevelt, William Harvard Taft, Warren Gamaliel Hardy, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, Harry S. Truman. What's funny is Harry S. Truman was a 33rd degree Scottish Rite Mason at the Belton Lodge, number 450 in Missouri. And he's also the 33rd President of the United States. Gerald R. Ford. There's a few more of them, actually. I don't know why there's only this small select. This is the building of King Solomon's Temple. With Hiram Abiff. Right here. The building of King Solomon's Temple. I'll just get the illustrations in this because the last one doesn't have any of these front of text illustrations. And then I'll link the previous video of going down in this book right here, showing off most of these Ruth and Boaz. Because I did a previous one with this book by itself. But just give like a couple flips of these pages to give a rundown, because I've already been through most of these. And if anybody wants a more in-depth video, leave a comment down below. And for the truth seekers that want to see it, let me know. So we'll skip a little bit more questions and answers with pertinent information relating to biblical word phrases, characters, events, and places associated with the ritual and teachings of Freemasonry. Growth of Freemasonry in recent years. York Rite. Year of Light. Saul leads Israel in victory over the Ammonites. Samuel meets Saul. Saul destined to become king of Israel. The Jews reminded of former kindness. God's call to repentance. Yeah, this is they got pictures. This other one does, but these aren't really too important. So, old text references. Most of these images you can find on Google. There's Molech. Malta, like Knights of Malta. Herod the Great. Concordance. Palestine, Canaan. Let's see, what is this? Peninsula of Sinai, Sea of Galilee. But yeah, that's about it for this one. If you want a more in-depth video, let me know. But moving on to my last one. Alright, now this one I actually sought out on my own intuition, because all these other ones that I just covered don't hold what this one has inside of it. It's very similar, but this one has a lot little more into it. And this is the one that truth seekers usually go to but don't know what it's called or where to look or what to type in to receive any kind of like information regarding it. But this also is a Oxford Text Bible. This is the male version of that one that I just shown right now, the pocket edition one. This is the Freemason. This is the Oxford Text Masonic Bible. This is the one that has all the Illuminati Egyptian, you know, Babylonian, Phoenician symbolism inside of it. This one is previously owned by several people, actually. Presented by... Now, this one actually has artwork in it, the beginning as well, so we'll go through most of that. These are names, though. You know, I bought this, so I'm allowed to show this. It's now my property. Take it up to the person who sold it. If anybody knows any of these people. Holy Bible and Freemasonry. What is this? Now this one I'm going to do another page cover like I did the reference heirloom one. How the Bible became a great light. Story of the English Bible. Skip a little bit. It's the actual Genesis. The legend of the temple. The Masonic story of building a King Solomon's temple. Oh no, I didn't skip any really. The legend of the temple. King Solomon's temple. So with the mythology surrounding Freemasonry, they originate their roots back to King Solomon's building of his temple, and you know, the architect Mason, stonemason Hiram Abiff, that built it. But theoretically, we don't know that to be really the case. You know, they could have formed later on, but this is where the story, though, to the foundation draws its inspiration. The Bible and Masonic ritual. The Ark of the Covenant. All right, let's see. The Master Workman. Exodus. I put little sticky notes in this one that I wanted to show off. Hebrews. Let's see, what is this? Harmony of the Life. So this is like a context. There's a Bible concordance like the other ones. So we'll skip a little bit to some interesting parts. Illustrations. Let's see. Any more other illustrations? Let's go. No. All right, here we have plate one. Egyptian god and goddesses. Ptah, Amun, Ra, Thoth, the creator, the father of the gods, the sun god, scribe of the gods. So this is in the back of the ox. So for the ones that want to see this, because people have showed these in previous videos, this right here, this one, if you want to find it, this is the Oxford Text Masonic Bible. Should be easy to find with that titling. And this is the one that has all the Egyptian Babylonian stuff in the back of it. All right, let's go. We'll go flip a page. Don't need that no more. Here on this one, we have Egyptian god and goddesses continued. The goddess Neith, Osiris, Sekhet, Happy, or Hapi, the weaver, judge of the dead, Osiris, the chief deity, the sun flame, god of, the god of the Nile River. Now, plate three, Amun Hetep III, king of Egypt, about B.C. 1500, offering incense before the Ark of the God, Amun-Ra, king of the gods. All right, I think I got that. You know, showing pretty well. Let's move along. Judgment scene from the papyrus of Anil, about B.C. 1400. The weighing of the heart of the hall of the hall of double truth in the presence of Osiris, judge of the dead. Don't need this anymore. Plate 5. The soul revisiting the body. Vigenet from the papyrus of Aunt Annie about BC 1400, showing Annie's soul in the form of a human-headed bird revisiting the mummied body on a bier in the tomb. Bier. I don't know how to say that. British Museum papyrus. See. Plate 6. Strangers coming into Egypt from a tomb of the 12th dynasty. Did I say dynasty? 12th. I don't know. I don't know if I'm saying that right. About BC 2400 at Beni Hassan in Upper Egypt. Egyptian granaries. From a wall painting in a tomb at Thebe. Let's see. Another plate. Egyptian brickmakers. Next one, names of Assyrian, Babylonian, and Persian kings mentioned in the Bible. One side of the black obelisk set up by Shalmaneser the second, king of Assyria, about 800 to 825 BC to record the victories of the 31 military expeditions of his reign, from a black stone obelisk discovered at Kala Nimrud, now in the British Museum. Let's see what we got next. Six-sided cylinder. Extract from the annals. Something. Worship of the Babylonian sun god. Seen from a stone tablet recording the restoration of the temple of the sun god at Sippara near Babylon by Nabopal-Iddina, king of Babylon, about BC 900. It's funny how these Masons record most of this. And these this one right here, this one's more in depth. There's another plate. That's a very popular image. This one has maps too, but they're kind of fucked up and I don't want to mess with them. But I believe that was it. Yeah, that's we got note tabs. But other than that, we got more maps. But we already showed the maps. But other than that, this is my, book overhaul. Masonic book overhaul. minus the Apocrypha and the Nag Hammadi. Thought I would show this off for those who've been waiting on this. You know, here we go. But to keep this short, you know, thanks for tuning in. If you got any more questions or want to see what else is in some of these, or have questions to what some of these say about the references and the Bible texts, let me know. And I'll be sure to record those when I have free time to do so. So other than that, my name is 2 Liter J. This is the Sacramento Truth Movement. And I will catch y'all in a later video. Thanks for tuning in. Subscribe, like, and share. We are heavily censored, heavily shadow banned at this page, so every bit of help counts. If you have a favorite YouTuber, make sure to send my videos and more directly maybe this video to them to maybe spark interest and take notice to who we are. And yeah, catch y'all later. Thank you. Peace out.